Okay. One day. We are reviewing their medicine and technology. He's just sitting in the room. He wasn't assistant.
Some of you may think he is a president.
Okay. My name is Mr.
At the age of 11, my father died and I was able to support.
This is my name.
I have one of the ones from the Royal Navy. Came
not yet.
I'm not so
good
at it.
I made this because people couldn't bring them.
I then joined the
because it cost much of like
$6,000. And
later then okay, so. It has 26 random characters. If you don't know what characters are, then
was elected Lieutenant Colonel of the French Militia and then Mayor.
I had a project where I printed the German translation to English.
So I decided to do the columnist and I was elected president.
It was powered by a European paper, only rich in the church.
I then retired by my wife home
before I made this. So when I made it, the poor could buy and afford books. In conclusion, education is our political safety, and without my printer, you could not have textbooks, which I think is really everybody knows.
Good job.
Well, I'm going to tell y'all about my fascination. I met Virginia, a southern country doctor that has studied my natural surroundings in the city. I've studied nature since my childhood. In 1840, I found out smallpox, or another name for it, speckled monster, was from cowpox. I tested it on my 11-month-old son and lots of other people. Most of my patients were farmers or even people that lived on farms with cattle. I was awarded $30,000 for my vaccine. In conclusion, cultures of the past impact our lives today and tomorrow. So I would appreciate y'all if y'all appreciate me for my vaccination. This is my certificate.
I would appreciate it. In 1839, I took a teaching job in Kentucky to prepare for medical school. I'm Elizabeth Blackwell, the first woman to receive a medical degree. In 1845, I moved to Asheville, North Carolina, where I taught school, and with the help of physician John Dickinson, I studied medicine in my spare time. 1847 was the worst and best year I had. The good news was that I got admitted to a medical college, and the bad news was that I got admitted as a drug. After that, I was banned from practicing in most hospitals, so I moved to Paris, where I had training, and during my training in Paris, I contracted a terrible eye disease, and during those times that Abraham Lincoln was elected president of the U.S. in Civil War, I was training women to be nurses so that they can help the soldiers. In conclusion, I stood up for what I believed in, and no matter what people said, that women couldn't be doctors. Are there any questions?